Shweta from Miss Pink Shows and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a makeup tutorial on this look right here, which is a perfect everyday makeup look for all you college students or all you working women out there who want to or like to wear makeup on an everyday basis. This literally took me 5 minutes to do, and you can recreate this look exactly in under 5 minutes, and it's using all drugstore products, so yeah, you can totally access them. They're very easy on the pocket, easily available everywhere. So yes, I've tried keeping this as recreatable and as simple and everyday like as possible, so I really hope you guys like it. And yes, if you want to know how to get this look, then please keep on watching. Alright, so I'm done with my basic skincare, my everyday skincare, and the last thing that I put on is a sunscreen. I'm gonna move on to my makeup now. So the first step is, of course, applying something for the base, and I'm gonna be using a foundation. So this is the Maybelline Super Skin Foundation in the shade 310. Now I'm gonna take one full pump of this foundation. This is more than enough for an everyday lightweight coverage. Now, a lot of people like using a BB or a CC cream. I used to do that when I was in college, but I stopped doing that because the BBCC creams you get in the market, they're not your skin tone A. And second thing, you are wasting your money on that, because if you apply a light layer of foundation like I am right now, you will sort of get a really everyday kind of a coverage. And when you want to build it up, you can just apply a thick layer of the foundation or layer it up and get the full coverage that you want. So why waste your money over a BBCC cream? I hope that makes sense. That's why I completely stopped using a BB or a CC cream, and this works really well for me. You can also mix your foundation with your everyday moisturizer and get a sheer coverage. Anyways, I'm just using my YBB Makeup Perfector, and I'm just gonna blend this out. And as you can see, that this is blending super easily, and it's a really good match also, so it makes it a really good, you know, everyday kind of a foundation. I'm taking some on my under eyes as well as a concealer. I'm not going to be applying a concealer today, and I'm not going to apply too much of my foundation, just a light layer. So when you want to keep it very natural looking, you can't really go with, you know, heavier layers or go for full coverage, because that will make it look a little fake. So yeah, this is the max I apply for an everyday base. The next step is setting this in place and making sure it does not budge at all. So I'm going to take this compact from Oriflame. This is from their color box range. This is their face powder, and it also comes with a puff. So I'm just picking some up with the tip of the powder puff, and I'm just gonna set in my under eye area like so, because we have applied a foundation there. It will start to crease really soon, so you want to make sure that does not happen. I'm also taking a tad bit on my smile lines, because I do crease there quite a bit, and a little over my T-zone, because again I get oily there. Moving on to the third step, which is the brows. Brows can make a lot of difference in making you look put together, and I've really been liking the whole natural feathered brow effect that's going on right now. So for that, I'm first going to take the Essence Make Me Brow. This is a brow mascara, and I'm just going to remove all of the excess from this. And what I'm going to do is start combing out my brows in an upward and outward direction like so. Okay, now I have a few little more gaps in my brows that I want to fill just to make them look a little complete, but I'm going to do that sometime later, because my brow mascara is wet right now, and if you try filling in your brows with wet brows, it's going to be a clumpy mess. So I'm going to move on to my lashes, which is all the eye makeup that I'm going to be doing today. So I'm using the L'Oreal False Lash Superstar, and I'm just going to take the black side of the mascara and apply a thick coat to both my upper and lower lashes. Okay, now that our lashes are done, our brows are also quite dry. So I'm gonna take this brow pencil from Maybelline. This is the Fashion Brow, and I love this for an everyday use. It's super quick and looks really natural. So all I'm gonna do is just fill in those little gaps to give my brow a nice shape. And literally, that is all I'm gonna do. Okay, moving on to the next step, which is using a blush. So using a blush can make it look a lot more natural actually for your makeup, and it makes you look just a lot more happier, flushier and fuller. So yeah, for that I'm going to take the Lakme 9to5 blush. This is in the shade Coral Punch and it's a beautiful coral shade, and I'm actually going to use this brush that comes along with it. I generally don't like using these brushes, but I'm just going to show you how to use them if you were to use them. So I'm just going to tap off all of the excess. And I'm first just applying it onto my cheeks like so. Then I'm gonna remove all of the excess onto my hand. And then I'm just gonna try and blend it out with this brush. Moving on to highlighting, so I want that glow from within kind of a look which looks really natural and, you know, healthy. So for that I'm using a cream highlighter by Maybelline. This is their Master Strobing Stick and this is in the shade Nude. So I'm first just gonna apply this on all of the areas that I like to highlight. So my cheekbones, the tip of my nose, in between my brows and my cupid bow. And with my finger, I'm just gonna blend it out. Alright, finally coming to the lips. So I wanted something that is bright but not too bright, something with undertones of browns and nudes, and something that's long wearing. So this one from Colourbar, it's just perfect for that. So this is their Kiss Proof Lip Stain in the shade Hot Latte, and yeah, I just love this lip color to bits. So guys, that was it for this tutorial. I really hope it was useful and you guys liked it. And if you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel, the link is down below. And I will see you soon in my next video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.